Hi everyone, I'm Shauna and welcome to my channel. Today's video is a winter wardrobe update. So for the winter season, which I would say we're in full swing of right now, I am not creating a whole new separate wardrobe. Instead, what I'm doing is showing you the pieces that are coming in for winter and then also the pieces that are leaving for fall. The reason for that is because I actually brought my capsule wardrobe to you pretty late in the season, like verging on what is winter weather here in Ontario. Normally, I would have preferred to bring my fall capsule, you know, end of September, maybe even mid-September. So it can really represent that transitional season. But I brought to you fairly late, just, you know, circumstance, things happen. So what I realized this year is that the differences between fall and winter aren't as significant as they would have been if I was filming or I brought to you the video in September. I have my tea here. I can't find my other mug. So I have my little fall mug here, which was around last time I filmed this video. So I'm gonna talk you through what's leaving and why, and then I'm also gonna be talking to you about what I'm bringing in, as well as talking just a little bit about winter shoes. I realize I haven't quite spent a lot of time on shoes on this channel, and I think winter shoes is like a really good opportunity to do that. I have about 5 pairs of kind of like everyday winter shoes. So let's dive into it and let's start talking about what's leaving. So all the things that are leaving are on this side, and I want to talk to you about first this guy. So this is my Franken Oak speckled sweater, and when I saw her on camera last time, I knew it was time. She is officially being retired. She has been worn over 100 times. She has been worn, I actually think it's significantly closer to 200, might even be over 200. The second season that I owned it, I wore it about 60 times. And that, you know, doesn't count the first season or this year. So she is not actually being decluttered. She's just being shifted over to loungewear. I love her to pieces, and I will genuinely, she will not leave my collection until she is actually in pieces. She just does not, she has not aged well, which is just, I think, a result of the color and just a lot of fading. And this is just not a piece that I feel my best in like I used to. It's just a piece that is like so comfortable and familiar. The central reason why the next 4-ish pieces are going to be removed from my winter capsule, partly weather, but way more significantly, school. I am taking a leave of absence, which means I will no longer be in school as of January 1st. And I will be out for a year, and I'm going to be using that time to transition myself out of school. That's all I really want to say at this point, but there will be no more meetings, no more going to campus, no teaching, none of that. And I still want to be able to look nice at home, but I'm removing my most dressy pieces. And if I ever honestly feel inclined to wear them, like, they're still going to be around, like they're going to be in a drawer, they're going to be tucked away, but still easily accessible if I want to look a little nicer. But also, my nicest clothes aren't just gone. So that's the primary reason why the blazer is going, and as well as this blouse. I am so gonna bring back the Emmy blouse in the springtime. I think that this is just a little bit too light for winter, and because it's too light for winter, and then I also don't have a ton of uses for it, it's just gonna go, and I hope to bring her back for spring. I'm also leaving the black cardigan. The maroon one is still gonna be in my wardrobe because I do like wearing it kind of around the house, but I don't need two when this season is so cold. And I was a little torn about the blazer because I'm thinking, you know, maybe I might wanna wear it. So she's just gonna officially go into my professional wear capsule that is like in my actual closet. So if there's a day that I just want to feel like a bit of a boss, like she's right there and easily accessible. But in my mind, this doesn't belong here because it will not be an everyday or even every month kind of piece. So this is a long sleeve kind of tight shirt from Zara. So I also have one in blue from H&M. It's not quite as tight, but very similar. That one is being removed as well to the occasion wear capsule. This is too light to really wear on its own, but great for dressing up and dates. And those things are not every week occurrences. Those might be, you know, once or twice a month in that kind of clothing. So just a different capsule. These two pants, one I'm actually decluttering, which is this guy. I bought these a couple of years ago because I really wanted that beige kind of minimalist. If you know the kind of pant I'm talking about, then you know. I'm gonna see if I can find a picture or two to throw up on the screen. These pants were my attempt at creating that, but they just didn't live up to the expectation. And every time I wore these, I hated the way that they look. I put them in a capsule, my 10x10 capsule, because I like the idea of these, but I did not actually like them. In reality, I kind of hate them, honestly. I don't like the way that they look. So they are being decluttered. They're not gonna be replaced simply for all the reasons that I talked about in regards to why some of my dressier pieces are leaving. It just doesn't make sense to replace them at this time. And then the black ones, which are truly a favorite, they're leaving because they're too dressy. So the last two pieces have a bit of their own reasoning. This one is getting moved to my spring capsule. This is a shirt that I kind of regret buying, only because I felt like once I had this in my hands, I should have known better. So I really like the style of this sweater, and I think it's a very attractive, very, it looks good on me, and I like the way it looks on me, but this is so thin, and you can see it's like tissue paper thin. I have heard people talk about this as a good winter sweater, which is why I bought it, and also because I liked the style, like the way that it looked on me. It is way too thin to wear for winter. Incredibly thin. It does not make any sense having this in my wardrobe. And because this is a transitional sweater, I mean, I can wear it for fall and I can wear it for spring. I don't know. I kind of wish that I took that into account when I opened the box, and I kind of wish I returned it, because what I wanted and what I was expecting was something that would be a little bit heavier. And then the last thing is, I guess, similar. I wish that I did more due diligence when I was trying this on. I got so infatuated with the color and the style, I wasn't being as cautious about fit as I should have. This top is so wide on me. I have very, very narrow, very petite shoulders. There's no bra that I own that I can wear with this. It exposes every bra. And if I keep it, I would want to take it this in to maybe like here. It's too wide to the point of impracticality. And I did not really notice that when I tried it on, because I just got so excited. Oh wow, it's Cezanne, it's this new thing. This is gonna be packed away, the tag is still on. And I don't know actually if I want to invest that time and that money into getting this fixed. So I'm gonna put this away for the season, and then bring this back out in spring, and then reassess how I feel at that point. This is not a shirt that's going to lose its value in a couple of months. Like if I sold it now versus if I sold it 3 or 4 months from now, it's like I could sell it for the same price. And I'm just somewhat disappointed that I was not more cautious when I ordered this sweater or this shirt. I really do think it's beautiful, and a beautiful style, and like I have no problems with like how it looks on me. It's just the shoulders. So those are all the things that are leaving for fall, and I want to talk about what's coming in. To replace those two pairs of pants that I rolled out, I'm bringing in these two straight leg pairs of jeans. These were both initially meant to be in the fall capsule, and there was a point actually, I think it was in September or October, where I pulled these out because I like hated the way that they looked on me, and I just couldn't stand them anymore. And so I put them in my like quarantine bin, the things that I'm thinking about actually decluttering. And back in like the end of November, I started actually longing for these and I pulled them back out, and I've worn them like 6 times since. And so these are officially back in the capsule. Kind of similar thing to these. I pulled these out because I felt like a straight leg was just maybe more of my spring summer style and not really my fall winter style. Mostly because I roll up these pants, and to me they look best rolled, and there isn't enough fabric to roll them and also have my ankles covered. So my ankles were too cold when I was wearing running shoes or flats or whatever it was in the fall. So now that I'm wearing boots, I do also like a kind of the same thing. I put these under my bed. I didn't put them into the declutter pile, and I straight up was like, wow, I'm missing these. And so I pulled them back out. I actually wore these ones yesterday. They're just it right now, especially as I'm spending more time at home. I will actually wear these at home, and I have like to work around the house and all that kind of thing. Let's now talk about some returning favorites. First up is this J. Crew sweater. I got this, I think, in 2019. I don't believe I wore this much last year, and the main reason for that is because of this collar. It has it at the top, and then also around these sleeves. One of the reasons why I bought this is because I thought this would be a great kind of elevated piece, but it felt a little strange wearing this kind of sweater when I was at home working. But I've kind of since changed my mind a little bit. This kind of feels like the best thing to wear at home working because it's ultimately just a sweatshirt. And so I can put this with a pair of jeans, and I just feel dressed up by wearing basically what I'm wearing today. As soon as I saw this under my bed, I was like, oh my gosh, this is perfect. And it's green. Green is, I think, my favorite color. So such a joy to have this back. Another kind of classic for me, another green piece. This is the Renew sweater from Everlane. I did consider buying this in a different color. I think I considered it last year as well. This is one of the warmest things that I own. And I do have one other thing that's under my bed. It is the warmest thing that I own. It's this super chunky, like oatmeal tan colored turtleneck. So thick. So those two things are the thickest things I own. This I'm perfectly fine wearing around the house. The other one is just so chunky, so thick. It's for those coldest days. I didn't bring it out because I am back to just being at home, working at home again. That is the kind of sweater that you wear when you're going out and it's cold. So if I need it, it's there. I just don't expect it to be a main part of the capsule. So she is back. I think this will be my third year. Love this to pieces. The last piece is this sweater. I tried to show this in a video recently, but it's kind of hard to, it was a little difficult to show. This is a mock neck style sweater. I feel so cool when I wear this. So cool, so chic. I love wearing this with the black pair of jeans, and then also like putting my hair up. I love that look. I also don't like turtlenecks on me, so a mock neck is kind of my sweet spot. I have two more returning favorites. One you've probably seen around the channel already. It is this red sweatshirt. Love this, wore this yesterday. I had to fish this out of my my laundry bin. Does this ever happen to you when you put on a shirt and like, oh, I have to brush my teeth, and then you get the toothpaste on it as you're about to leave, and then you walk out in the world with toothpaste on your sweater? That was me yesterday. So she's gotta be washed. And then the other red sweater I have is this J. Crew. This one is like my dressier red, and I wear this most around the holidays. Love this, and I do actually really like the way red looks on me. I feel like my face just gets so much brighter. So I have a couple of new in pieces to talk to you about, but these aren't really things that I bought for myself. These are actually gifts from people that I know. I have people in my life who will buy things for me when they go shopping. So these were two gifts. I really want to experiment with this guy. I've really been thinking about Argyle, so I'm glad to have this. Also very much my aesthetic. And then the last three things are things that I bought for myself. The first, which is I guess the newest, is this top from Banana Republic. This is the softest. Oh my goodness. This in my opinion, is what the Everlane sweater should have been. The arms are very similar. And then on the front of the shirt, it has this like ribbing detail. I love this. I saw this when I went to the mall back in October, and I waited till they had a sale, and I got this like 40% off in November. I've already worn it a couple of times. I just love this. And the reason why I bought this is because I have two tan sweaters. One of them is a J. Crew like teddy sweater, darker brown than this. It just doesn't fit right, not quite the right color. And then one other tan shirt. This is meant to replace both of them. And so the other two are not in the capsule, obviously, because I'm testing it out to see if this can be a replacement for both of them. And my answer so far is yes. It's been in here for about 3 weeks now. I can't speak highly enough about this. The other thing is something I got on Poshmark actually back in the summer. This was late August purchase, I think. This is when I was having some destructive spending habits, honestly, and then put it away and then kind of forgot about it. This is a black crew neck sweater. And then the sleeves, look at the sleeves. I think they're so beautiful. And I think that this is just like a really fun kind of, this is like a fun sweater that I could put with some jeans and a boot and dress it up. That was kind of my vibe for it. I truly cannot get over the sleeves, and I still love it. The last item here, which is something you may have seen on the channel already, is the James sweater. I got this when I did those Cezanne purchases back in September. I just decided to put this away for the winter time. So it's just kind of been packed away, and I tried it on and made sure it fit and everything. But it had been a couple of months since I looked at it. And when I tried it on again, I actually went out for a date in it. I am over the moon with the fit of this. This is one of the most beautiful fitting knitwear pieces that I own. I would honestly consider getting this in a white. I really wanted a white. So my white H&M sweater, actually, let me go get it. This, I think, is maybe 4 years old at this point, or this is the fourth year. This just does not look good anymore. Like, it just looks ragged. And I'm still gonna wear it this season because I just don't feel like replacing it this year. And I think it's one of those things where ideally, yes, you would replace it, but I feel like I could wear it for one more season, so I'm going to. And this has been a favorite of mine. So I think if they make the James in a white, I would totally buy that maybe next year, because it's just so beautiful. I'm actually not sure if I mentioned this in the capsule, the fall capsule, but this guy is also in the winter capsule as well. Let's talk about winter footwear. And where I live, I feel like owning a couple of pairs of boots, kind of a necessity. So I have five. Don't know why I got so confused about that. So I have five pairs of boots, and they all kind of serve different purposes. So the first one is my winter boot. These are Sorels. These are heavy freaking duty. These are black, and I think that like they just go with my winter coat, which is also black. And they have that lug sole. These have really great grip, like right, they're dirty. They have like, they have really, really great grip. And I just wanna compare the bottom to these guys. These have no traction at all. So when you compare them, you can see that within the pieces here, there's extra grip, like extra little grippies, whereas these are completely smooth. So these were my winter boots. I think I got these in 2019. These are dirty because I hiked with them recently. So what I learned from these is that they are not warm at all, and then they have no grip, and they're also not very tall. So when I was commuting anywhere, I would get caught in the snow and snow would get in, which still happens with these ones. So I actually thought about decluttering them, but they do serve a purpose. These are good in light snow and also going on walks in muddy or slippery weather, slush. These are better than a rain boot in the wintertime because they do have some insulation. So these are great for those slushy, muddy days, especially on walks and the transition of the season. So I'm very glad I kept these. because I don't actually know what I would wear at those at those points, which does happen here really often, both when you're coming into the season and going out, but also if ice thaws, it just can be super messy and slushy. And we've had that happen quite a few times already. And then these guys are super heavy duty. Like, these are legitimately heavy, but here's my thing. I will go for warmth over style any day. I refuse to be cold in the winter. It can be minus 30 here. Minus 10 temperatures are regular to be expected every winter here. It can get colder, and it does every season, but minus 10, like, it could be in a week here and the whole week will be in minus 10. It does get colder every season, but like pushing past minus 15 to minus 20, even minus 25, that's not every day. That might be like once a week or a couple of times in the season. I need these for warmth and for snow. And if you live in a cold weather climate like mine, investing in a boot doesn't have to be Sorel. I've had a really great experience with these boots, but investing in a heavy duty, waterproof, and really warm boot, amazing. The cold weather ensemble that I've created has made it so the only places I feel cold are my face and parts of my leg where my coat is not covering. So do yourself a favor and get yourself a heavy duty boot this holiday season. So that covers it for like the coldest weather wear. I have two nice boots. They do look really similar. These boots right here, I got in 2018. I love them. I think they're a super stylish boot, and they have a high enough heel that I still feel comfortable walking basically anywhere in. But if I'm going for an evening stroll, these would not be the boots to wear. I do wear these for fall and winter. I think they're beautiful for those, and I've already worn this three or four times since October, maybe even more. And this is a boot to me that is so classic, so timeless, that I could see myself wearing these for 10 years. I've already had them for four at least, I think. These aren't going anywhere. And I feel like every person should have a black heeled boot if you wear a heel. So my newest pair are these Ralph Lauren boots. They have like an almond toe front, and then they have a much lower heel, and then this Ralph Lauren detail. These are comfortable to walk anywhere in. They have that low profile. I walked all around campus with these. Just a fabulous, I think, classy boot. I bought these because they reminded me of classy and sophistication. The last pair is a pair that I was honestly trying to replace. I don't think that they look that great. These were H&M by 2019, I think. They don't fit great. They're too loose without an insole, too tight with one, because they're not my actual size. I bought these in 2018 or 19 when the boot that I was wearing broke while I was at school, and I needed something now, and this was basically what I could find in the time allotted. I think that they're an okay boot, but not a favorite. I do wear them all the time because they do serve a purpose, and they're quick to pull on, and they're not a super fussy boot. I haven't quite found anything to replace these as of yet, so I think they're gonna stick around for another season.